trauma are we exposing kids to when we put them through metal detectors every day? What trauma, and you've heard it from three students sitting here, are we putting them through when they know that a gun would be in a classroom or a teacher is armed with a gun? When I was a building principal, I made it very clear to the SROs, you're not to go to a classroom until you get a call from an administrator. You're not there to interact with kids in a negative way in terms of responding to an incident. You're there to make sure that there's safety within the school, preferably outside, and that no one is coming in the school to harm our kids. And so making that expectation from day one, I was lucky and blessed enough to have two resource officers that connected with kids and that kids felt comfortable going to. But those were expectations that I made up front because I know what I want for my own, and I refuse to allow another student to go through more trauma interacting with a metal detector every single day. We do that when we go to a courthouse, and we do that when we go to the airport. I don't even like it when I go to the airport. The thought of it stresses me out. Not that I have anything in my bag. I'm just like, oh my gosh. Like when I go to the x-ray and I have to hold up my arms and just what is doing to me mentally. And by the time I get done and want to put on shoes, I'm like, do I really want to go fly on a plane right now? I'm not sure because I feel so stressed. And so my wondering all the time is, what are we doing to our kids when we put them through a safety measure that we think is a safety measure that sometimes presents itself as a false safety measure? I don't have the answer either. It's just a perspective that I'll lend to this conversation because I know what it does to kids.